Good morning guys, welcome back to our channel. So today we are here with one more interview experience. So in this video we will be talking about Accenture interview questions that were shared by one of our subscriber friend. So this video would be really helpful for mid-level experienced candidates who are about to attend interviews, because there are a lot of good questions that has been shared. So we'll be talking about the questions in the upcoming slides. Before that, we will talk about the interview. So the role for which the candidate was interviewed was application development senior analyst. Experience of the candidate was 3.5 years. Salary we will discuss in the upcoming slides. So this is the screenshot of the mail that we got. Hi, I interviewed for position of application development senior analyst for experience of 3.5 years. Salary offer was so and so LPA. Below are the questions asked in Accenture, and the mail we got on 13 July. So let's get further into the video, guys. Before getting into the questions part, let us talk a bit about the challenges that lot of our subscriber friends face. How to get into the product based companies or into the companies which work on cutting edge technologies. Here we have found one platform which will give a solution to the above challenges, and the platform is Relevel. So Relevel by Unacademy is a platform which gives an opportunity to work with most of the leading product based companies like Cred, Razorpay, Urban Company, 1MG, and there are many more. To apply for the opening, it's very easy. You just need to register and take the test, and upon clearing the test, you will be shortlisted for the interview. So once you get shortlisted for the interview, you will be provided a special guidance by Relevel team in tracking the interview, and the amazing thing is, this entire process happens just within a week when compared to other platforms where there is no end to this thing. And currently there are two offers that are going on here. So for our subscribers, there is special 10% discount. You can avail the coupon code from the description link. And two, if you get a job, the entire registration fee what you have paid will be refunded. So what are you waiting for? Register, take the test, get your dream job. The platform details and the coupon code are given in the description of the video, and don't miss this golden opportunity. So here is the first question, guys. Explain about project and architecture. So this is a very common interview questions and a mandatory interview question irrespective of your interview. So you have to talk about the project architecture in detail, and there are videos on our channel regarding the same as well. You can get watch those videos and get benefited out of it. Coming to the next question, new features of Java 8, like might be the question would be like, what are the new features in Java 8? So Java 8 provides following features for Java programming: lambda expression, method references, functional interfaces, stream API, default methods. There are many more. You can go through the entire list that is listed on the screen. These are the new features that got introduced in Java 8. And after listing down all the features, expect a question from those things for sure. Next question is, what are streams in Java? So stream is a sequence of objects that supports various methods which can be pipelined to produce the desired result. And one more important thing I would like to talk is, only the questions were shared by our friend, and the answers we have added it for reference. Just as a note, we have added the answers. Coming to the next question here, what are lambda functions? A function that can be created without belonging to any class. A lambda expression can be passed around as it was an object and executed on demand. So this is what a lambda function is. What all collections have you worked on? So list down all the collection classes that you have worked on. Example, you can use array list, hash map, linked list, concurrent hash map. And I would say list down all the toughest collections as well, because be prepared on those things in advance, and once you talk about them, so it will definitely put on some weight in your selection. So many people don't talk about concurrent hash map, but you prepare about concurrent hash map and say that I have worked in concurrent hash map in so and so scenario, and explain in detail how concurrent hash map works. So that will definitely add an advantage. Instead of working on normal hash map, you can say I have worked on concurrent hash map. That will definitely put on some weight in your selection process. explain internal working of HashMap. So basically HashMap works on the principle of hashing. So explain in detail like what will happen when we add an object, when we add a key value pair to a HashMap, and when we do a get operation. Importance of hashcode and equals method. Have to explain in detail like the contract between hashcode and equals and what impact it will have if we don't override it, or what all difficult scenarios, or how the application will behave differently if we don't override those things. The next question, difference between comparator and comparable. So these are the differences between comparator and comparable. We got some, took the screenshot from one of the site, so you can go through it. There are good differences, like 5 differences listed on the screen. You can add your own differences as well if you found any. So those was the question, comparator and comparable. Then there was a question on difference between array and ArrayList. So again, we have took the screenshot of one of the site, so you can go through, you can halt a video for a second and you can go through the differences between these two. So the major difference would be like array is fixed size, ArrayList won't be of a fixed size. Array is most of a homogeneous data types, and has coming to ArrayList, it would be of heterogeneous data type can be added there. What is method overloading and method overriding? So this is one of the important questions for 2 to 4 years of experience candidate, you can say. Like, so the answer would be like overloading occurs when two or more methods in one class have the same method name but different parameters. Overriding occurs when two methods have the same method name and parameters. Difference between abstract class and interface. So after Java 8 coming to picture, the difference is really minimal, but you can explain the difference between them before Java 8, like what all differences used to be between interface and abstract class, and in which scenario you would go with interface and in which scenario you would go with abstract class. What is final keyword? So we have to talk about the final keyword, where at what all places we can use final keyword. So basically we can use final keyword with variables, with methods, and at the class level as well. So whenever we are using it with a variable, if you make any variable as final, you cannot change the value of final variable, it will be a constant. So basically if you want to declare constants, you can go with final keyword. Methods that are marked with final keyword, we cannot override those methods in the child classes. And if a class is, if we are making a class as final, we cannot extend the class. And one best thing would be give real-time examples of these things where Java is already using this. So one example could be string class. You cannot extend string class here. So like that, you can take Google's few examples and be ready. The next question, what is immutable immutable class in Java? So immutable class means that once an object is created, we cannot change its content. In Java, all the wrapper classes are immutable classes, and string class is also immutable. And you can expect a cross question here, like why string is immutable, why all the wrapper classes are immutable. So be prepared on those type of questions as well. Difference between string and string builder. So a string created by string class is immutable, that is its original value cannot be modified, but a string created by a string builder can be modified easily, hence it is mutable. So basically string is immutable, string builder is mutable. Trying to modify a string created by string class does not modify it, but instead a new string is created, which leads to memory waste. But no memory is wasted when a string created by string builder is modified. So that is the difference. Which annotations have you used and explain its uses? So talk about all the annotations that you know, how they work and what's their purpose is. So be prepared and be cautious while explaining them. If you don't know about some annotation, how it works, so don't say even if you work, because definitely there would be a next question saying explain about what is the, how it works. So prepared on that thing. Explain the Spring Boot application. So Spring Boot application annotation is used to mark a configuration class that declares one or more @bean methods and also triggers auto configuration and component scanning. It's same as declaring a class with @configuration, @enable auto configuration, and @component scan annotation. Next question is difference between dependency injection and IOC container. Like lot of mid-level candidates gets confused here. There is no comparison between these two. The inversion of control is a design pattern which helps to invert the control of object creation. Dependency injection is a design pattern which implements IOC principle. So basically, dependency injection is a design pattern, like it implements IOC. There is no difference. So types of dependency injection in Spring. So mostly we talk about constructor and setter, and mostly the interviewer will also be satisfied if we talk about constructor and setter. But apart from those ones, there are lot of types that are present. You can explore them. What is the default scope of a bin? So basically, like here we are talking in the context of Spring. So what is the default scope of a bin in Spring? So it's singleton. Even you may be asked to prove it, like how you are saying it's a singleton bin. So you have to compare the reference. Explain all scope types of a bin. So basically there are five: singleton, prototype, request, session, global session, and singleton is the default one. Based on your requirement, you can change the scope of the bin. How do you change port of application in Spring Boot? So basically using in the application.properties, if we override server.port value, we can change the port of the application. How to exclude dependency from POM? So here is a code snippet, like how can we, using exclusions and exclusion tag, we can exclude the dependency from the POM. How do you connect to DB? This answer differs from project to project depending upon your project requirement and what ORM framework you are using. It differs. Difference between error and exception. So we can define it as an error, like indicates a serious problem that a reasonable application should not try to catch, whereas exception indicates a condition that a reasonable application might want to catch. How to handle exceptions? So this again depends on the project, like how you want to implement the exceptional handling scenario. Like entire framework can be designed here. Next question, how to create custom exception class? So this is a sample code just by extending an exception class, and in the constructor, if you are calling the super with the string, we need to have a constructor with a parameterized constructor, and we should pass that value. So this is a simple way of creating an exception, custom exception class. So these were the questions, guys, that were shared with us. So here is the complete mail. So the salary offered was 14.2 lakh per annum. So here is a mail, you can see, hi, I have interviewed for the position of application development senior analyst for experience of 3.4 years. So salary offer was 14.2 lakhs per annum. As already discussed, this mail we got on 13 July 2021. Below are the questions asked in Accenture. So these were the questions that we have already gone through. These are the 26 questions. So you can halt for a video, and if you want to cross verify, you can cross verify. So your videos are lot helpful and have really helped me in cracking interview. Please hide my name and email. Sure, that's the reason we have striked out the email, like my pick and the name. So guys, if you want to share, so one more thing, this is about Accenture. This is the new section that we started to add in the all the videos, because this has become a mandatory interview question, like to know about the major clients. So you can go through this, like what is about Accenture. Even for the freshers, that would be helpful. So the question could be like, what do you know about Accenture? So Accenture is known for its divergence range of service offerings and have five main practice areas. They include strategy management, digital technology, and operation consulting. The firm is consistently ranked as one of the top firms in the world. Fortune magazine ranked it 60th in their latest 100 best companies to work for issue. Accenture's current client list includes 94 of the Fortune 100 companies and more than 80% of the Fortune 500 companies. Some of its most notable clients include Microsoft, Adobe Systems, Siemens, Dell, etc. So if you're on our channel and for the first time, you can visit our channel and have a look at the interview, the company interviews that we have already shared. And if you are wondering like, who are we and what we do, we are basically a bunch of software engineers who attend interviews and then share our real-time interview experiences through these videos. And if you want to share your interview experience, feel free to reach at the email ID that is there in the description. And these are the companies that we have already shared, and there are many more as the, we cannot accommodate due to space, so we haven't mentioned those things. That's it. So if you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe, because there are a lot of interview questions that are already in the queue and that will be posted very soon. So to catch all the updates, you have to subscribe and click the bell icon. Like the video if you think that is helpful for you. You can share it to other technical platforms so that it might be helpful to someone who is looking out for similar kind of videos. You can provide the feedback by commenting the comment section. So that's it, guys. That's it in this video. Thank you for watching.